Welcome to the channel Data Science Demonstrated. In this video, you are going to see a radically different and a very innovative approach of dynamic pricing using generative AI. Dynamic pricing is used in many applications nowadays. For example, booking a hotel or booking a taxi or selling online products. In dynamic pricing, the price of the product is not fixed, but is based on various criteria such as the demand for the product, the date, the time, the social media interactions, etc., etc. Now, traditionally, we have used machine learning for dynamic pricing, and you can see one of my previous videos on this topic. But in this video, we are going to use a very different approach. We are going to use generative AI and large language models for dynamic pricing. The demo which I'll be showing you is also available on my platform, experiencedatascience.com. You can also try it out. No coding is required and it will be exciting. So my friends, let's jump into the demo, but do not forget to subscribe to the channel, like and comment on the video. In this video, you will see on how to use generative AI for dynamic pricing for an e-commerce marketplace application. The business context is about an e-commerce marketplace where the sellers put up products on the marketplace platform and the buyers buy the product. Now, what should be the right price of the product? In order to answer this question, we will use generative AI. The data which we'll be using has got product information such as the product category, the brand information, the item description, as well as the actual price at which the product was sold. Our task is to use all this data and then develop a generative AI model which can predict the price. In order to understand on how generative AI is revolutionary, let us first look at how the classical machine learning is used for dynamic pricing. In classical machine learning, we take the data, we do feature engineering, then we train a machine learning model using popular algorithms such as XGBoost or Random Forest. And then we use this model to predict the price. But with generative AI, the process changes radically. We take the data, we do the prompt engineering, and then we can use popular large language models such as GPT-4, fine-tune it, and then use the fine-tuned model to predict the price. The fine-tuning process takes the pre-trained large language model, then customizes it to the specific data set. And in our case, the model is fine-tuned to the product information. So why does this new approach work? And let me give you an intuition behind that. Large language models are basically the next word predictor model. So given an item description, we would like to predict the price. In the first example, the large language model sees the words such as iPhone 6, everything works perfectly, and then it can predict a higher price. Now, similarly, in the second example, the large language model sees words such as broken iPhone and then predicts a less price. Now, let us confirm this intuition. I've taken all the item description and I've passed it to OpenAI GPT model to obtain embeddings, which are numeric representation of item description. And then I have taken these embeddings and plotted them on a 2D scatter plot for visualization purposes. Now here is the visual where each dot is a product and the color of the dot represents the price. Now let me filter all the products which have a price between 160 and 190. Let me hover over these products to see what they are. So I see rose cold 38 millimeter Apple Watch works perfectly, and this is priced at 175. Now let me see another product, and this says rose gold Apple Watch reset to factory setting and all is ready to go. One small scratch on the watch face but cannot see it. Now this is priced at 166, which is a bit less than the previous one, probably due to the scratch. So it seems that the rose gold Apple Watch are priced around 160 to 170. So as you can see that the descriptions are a good indicator on what should be the price. Now, let me select the product items with a higher price, something between $350 and $550. Now, here I see iPhone 6S Gold 128 GB, which is priced at $450. Now, let me take another product item, and here I see that this is an iPhone 6S and 16 GB, which is less memory than the previous one, and which is also priced less at $351. So our intuition is correct. Item description with words such as works perfectly or higher memory will get higher prices. And item descriptions with words such as scratch or lower memory will get lower price. So this is a perfect example to use a large language model to predict the price. Now let's see this process in action. Let us first start with prompt engineering. A prompt has got three parts. The first is the system content, which indicates on how we want our fine-tuned model to behave. For example, we can say that you are an assistant which gives price of electronic items based on its description. Then the second part is the user content, which is the item description. And third part is the assistant response, which is the price. We can create a training data set which has got multiple product items for which the prices are known, and each record will have a prompt. And the training data set is then used to fine-tune the large language model. Now, for the large language model, I've used OpenAI GPT-4. The fine-tuning process will give a training loss analysis. Initially, the loss is high, but with each step in the training, the loss reduces and the fine-tuned model gets more accurate. Now, once the model is fine-tuned, we can use it to predict the price based on the description. For example, here there are some predictions of some product items. An iPhone 5C was actually sold at 81, and LLM or large language model predicted it correctly at 85, which is pretty close. Here we have an Apple Watch which was sold at 226, and the LLM predicted it correctly at 225, and which is also pretty amazing. Now, let me show you a demo using my platform, experiencedatascience.com. You can also try it out and see the magic of the LLM fine-tuning. So I will go to the experience dynamic pricing with generative AI. Now, here you see two data sets for dynamic pricing for Apple products. One is for fine-tuning, and other is to predicting the price. Now, if you want, you can upload your own data using the add button. Also, you can hover over the tip button to see what to do at each step. But for the moment, let me go ahead and select these two data sets, copy it, and make it ready to use. All right, so the data sets are now copied. So let me select the data set to fine-tune the model and go ahead and select analytics. Now here you see multiple tabs, and let us first start with the preview of the data. So I will select few records to display. I will select all the columns. I'll make some other settings and let us now execute. So in a while we see some sample data, and this sample data has got the brand name, the product details, and the description, as well as it has got the price. Now, let us go ahead and fine-tune the large language model based on this data. Let us first start by entering on how we want the fine-tuned large language model to behave. And here I'll say that you are an assistant which gives price of electronic items based on its description. Now, let us give the user content based on which the prompt engineering will take place. And here, we can give all the columns except the price. We can also choose to include the column names in the prompt. For example, if we choose not to include the column name, the prompt will be as shown over here. So here, there is no column name. However, if we choose to include the column name, The prompt will be as shown on the screen. The column name is prefixed before the value. But for the moment, let us say that we do not want to include the column name in the prompt. Now, we want our LLM assistant to reply back with the predicted price. So I will choose the price as the column for the assistant content. We will use OpenAI fine tuning. We can also choose to use 30% of the data to validate the model. Let us also save the output and let us launch the fine tuning. Now this step can take long time, but once it is done, we have the name of the fine tuning job. So let us take this job number and see its status. So I'll go to the fine tuning status and let me enter the job number. I'll also make some other settings and now execute. We might need to execute this step multiple times. If the job is successful, we will get the job status as successful. It will also give a model ID of the fine-tuned model. So let me now take this model ID and use it for dynamic pricing. However, before that, let me also change the data set to use the inferencing data set. Now, let me go ahead and predict the price of this inferencing data set and using our model. So I'll start by entering that you are an assistant which gives the price of electronic items based on its description. Let me also enter the user content, which is everything except the price. Let me also enter the fine-tuned model ID. We will also say that we do not want to prefix the column name as we did it in the training. We will also set the model as the OpenAI model. Now in the inference data, I have the actual price, but it is only for informational purpose so that we can compare it with the price which is predicted. Now let me make some other settings and execute this. So in a while, I'll get my predicted price, which is the column inference. I can compare it with the actual price and you can see that they are very close. So my friends, hopefully you have enjoyed this demo. I would recommend you to try it out and see on how this innovative approach works for dynamic pricing. Please do comment, please like, subscribe, and see you soon in another exciting demo video.